are you? This is Korean Buddhism, the sixth lesson. It's Identity, Culture, and History by Korea Dharma Master Venerable Onung Bogom, Dr. Lichia. What is the problem with Korean Buddhism? Currently, Korean Buddhism is in some sense facing a crisis. This is because the number of believers is decreasing, and there are few young generation who want to become monks. Of course, this issue cannot ignore the contemporary trend of de-religionization. Has there ever been a situation as strange as this in the 1700-year history of Korean Buddhism? The humiliating situation that monks suffered at the hands of Confucian scholars is unfolding due to the operation caused by policy of suppressing Buddhism and Confucianism during the Joseon Dynasty. As Buddhism emerged in India, it enjoyed the status of state religion at one time. Despite experiencing all kinds of trials and turbulence and spread to Southeast Asia, North India, and Central Asia, eventually reaching the East Asian countries of China, Korea, and Japan. Today, we are making effort to spread the tradition and culture of Korean Buddhism in Korea and abroad. Even though it is the same Northern Mahayana Buddhism, because we are Koreans, we are immersed in the Korean style Buddhism that developed and accumulated in Korea, and we practice praying and maintain the tradition through Korean style Buddhism. Korean Buddhism, which is a Buddhism with 1700 years of history and tradition, can be said to be the religion of Koreans. Not just the religion of Buddhists who directly believe in Buddhism, it is an undeniable historical fact that the ideals and cultural knowledge that Buddhism has left behind on our people, nation, and historia, leaving an indescribable mark. Even pagans would agree that no matter how much the influence of other religions is strong, the status of Buddhism cannot be lightly underestimated. Looking at the current state of Korean Buddhism, I feel a sense of shame as to how our Buddhism came to this point. Where on earth is Korean Buddhism headed? I ask myself, the question is whether this can be done. The most acute issue seems to be the issue of Sangha's rules. Moreover, in a situation where morality and ethical sense are paralyzed, it can be said that it is a series of sudden actions that seem to abandon even the original posture of the monastic order just for sake of gaining fame. The practice up to now has been to leave Buddhism to Buddhists. But now things are changing. The response of Buddhist figures outside the Buddhist community is that Buddhist issues should not be left only to figure within Buddhism. In particular, Buddhist intellectuals outside are rising up. From the perspective that people cherish Buddhism and that Korean Buddhism should not be like this. There is some sympathy and positive aspect in the steps taken by those who do not have enough time to teach and research. The most serious question is whether these people will come forward, intervene in sensitive issue of religion. The direct target is the Sangha, and direct attack is being made. Regardless of the truth about the problem, Buddhist intellectuals outside are wielding batons and raising their voices. Only a very small number of Buddhist media are showing signs of cooperating with them and moving together. The most disappointing thing about this situation is the attitude of so-called Buddhist intellectual group within Buddhism. What is the definition of intelligence? Aren't you an intellectual if you remain silent about social injustice and contradictions? From the perspective of an intellectual who pursues the truth, shouldn't there be some kind of a statement between pros and cons? Even though outside intellectuals who are also Buddhist are taking their steps forward and waging a movement, why are internal workers, such as professors who call themselves Buddhist intellectuals, Buddhist academic, media, preachers, temple workers, etc., silent? Shouldn't we do something about it? Isn't it reasonable that there should be some kind of expression of opinion, such as affirmation, denial, or silent agreement? If there is no expression of intention in the condemnation of external intellectuals, internal Buddhist intellectuals have no idea what their identity is, and are they just a scarecrow or a borrowed, barely sect? I think there has to be some kind of intention expressed. If Buddhism is making so much noise and they remain silent, can they really be called Buddhist intellectuals? There should be some kind of a response to right and wrong, and some kind of logic to protect Buddhism. But the attitude of not saying a word and only using it in the room makes me sigh that there really is no one in our Buddhism. Thank you very much for your listening. Thank you.